Assalamu alaikum. Why is Masjid Al-Aqsa so important? What every Muslim must know. It is a land Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indeed blessed, repeatedly referring to it as a blessed place in the Quran, directly or indirectly, almost 70 times. It is the second masjid on the face of the earth, originally built by Ibrahim alayhi salam 40 years after the Kaaba. It is the first Qibla. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, prayed towards Masjid Al-Aqsa for 17 months. The reward of praying there is 500 more times than anywhere else. There's over 40 ahadiths discussing the merits, the blessings, the sacredness of Al-Aqsa, in which the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prepared his blessed companions for the opening up of Palestine to Islam. Al-Aqsa is the only place on the face of the earth where all of the prophets and messengers from Adam to Muhammad were assembled together. They were led in salah by the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imagine the blessings and the sacredness of this land. Even Makkah al-Mukarramah didn't get this special privilege that Al-Aqsa has. Al-Aqsa is the land connected with hundreds of prophets and messengers of Islam, including Ibrahim alayhi salam, Nuh, Lut, Ishaq, Ya'qub, Yusuf, Musa, Harun, Dawood, Sulaiman, Yahya, Isa. Hundreds of messengers of Allah are buried in Al-Aqsa. It is a land which Musa alayhi salam so eagerly desired to enter during his incredible life. He wished to die in this blessed promised land, but his wish and desire wasn't fulfilled. Yet this ummah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam was blessed with its victory and its guardianship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala connected Masjid Al-Aqsa with this Muslim ummah forever through the miraculous journey of Al-Isra wal Mi'raj. Up until then, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam hadn't traveled to Masjid Al-Aqsa. Consider, so why does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take his messenger to Al-Aqsa? What purpose does it serve? Why gather all of the prophets and messengers in Al-Aqsa? Why not gather them at the Kaaba, which is more sacred than Al-Aqsa? Why not make the Kaaba and Makkah the point of ascension to the heavens as opposed to Al-Aqsa? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't give us the answers to all of these questions. However, there is no doubt about the indications. The messaging is absolutely clear. It is as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to tell us to pay special attention to Al-Aqsa, to not neglect it, to realize its importance, and perhaps giving us the heads up that the final frontier, the final challenge for this ummah will be this sacred land and the liberation of Palestine, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. The sacredness and importance of Al-Aqsa is forever established for all time to come. The spiritual, political, ideological connection between Al-Aqsa and the Muslims is clear. In conclusion, we love Al-Aqsa and it loves this ummah. Al-Aqsa is part of our Islamic identity, our faith, like Kaaba, like Mecca, like Madinatul Munawwara are part of our identity as Muslims. The issue of Palestine, Al-Aqsa, is not a Palestinian issue. It is an Islamic issue connected to all of the Muslim ummah. Today, this issue has also become a number one issue for all people of humanity, conscience, who oppose occupation and genocide. But the Muslim Ummah is the custodian and guardian of Al-Aqsa. It is the Muslim Ummah's responsibility to liberate Al-Aqsa once again and make it a place of worship for all people of faith, as Umar ibn Khattab did in 637, as Salahuddin Ayyubi did in 1187. Watch our next video on all your questions answered about Al-Aqsa.